Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're gonna check out the Rockwood ROO 233S. Now this Rockwood can sleep a small army and is super lightweight. Let me show you what it's all about. Now Rockwood is the number one selling lightweight travel trailer fiberglass unit on the market. There's several reasons for that, like their aluminum construction, their vacuum bonded walls, their 40 years of experience, and that comes through where they know where to put steel backers in the wall, they know where to reinforce the bars where the slide outs are out. Let me show you a few of those features on the outside, and then we'll go on to the inside. The 233S has three tip-out beds. That means you can have three queen-size beds that each can fit two adults on it that doesn't take up the room inside your coach. And they're able to pull this all off with the slide-out under 4,900 pounds dry, plus all your camping gear, of course. Let me show you some things on the front, like the power tongue jack. Now, this does have a light on the front, and you also have a secondary light over here. Now these are LED lights, so they don't use a lot of battery power, as well as all the lights in the entire coach. The battery disconnect on this allows you to disconnect the battery without having to take the battery box off and the strap that goes across there, because you always have something wearing down the battery, whether it's your propane leak detector, the radio, or just natural discharge of the battery. So if you can keep that battery from not discharging while it's in storage, you're much better off. Also, with these guys, it's very easy to tip these beds out. There's two locks on here that you just unlock with your key, and then this has zero bungee cords or straps that you have to worry about. That's important because that means all your stuff isn't falling out, including little kids. And then there's one bar that goes in the middle to hold this up. The other thing that Rockwood does different than their competitors is it has a steel bar that goes from here to here. That's important because as you're laying down on this, this guy does have an 800 pound weight limit. What happens is that bar, if you don't have that bar, this guy starts to bow over time. And then when you put this back up, it has a spot where dust and wind and rain and such can get inside the coach. Like I mentioned, the dry weight on this is 4,900 pounds. The GVWR is 6,300 pounds, giving you roughly about 1,400 pounds worth of cargo that you can put in the coach. The four stabilizers on this unit are super nice because you can use an electric drill and zip this down. There also is a manual crank that you can use to put these guys down. The electric drill gets it down obviously a lot faster. This guy has an antifreeze inlet, so instead of having to take apart your water pump, all you have to do is hook it up right here, put your jug of antifreeze, and this makes it a lot easier to winterize your coach to put it away for storage. One of the cool things about Rockwood is they are a vacuum bonded wall. What that means is you're 10 times less likely to have a problem compared to a pinch rolled wall. On delamination, the wall will start to bubble and then water can soak into there, and then you can eventually have the wall just fall off or rip off as you're going down the road if wind gets inside there. By buying a Rockwood, you're much less likely to have that happen to you because of the vacuum bonding process, where they put the wall together, suck out all the air, and hold that wall with a giant stacker press for several minutes. Also, you'll notice this is frameless windows. That's a super nice feature because instead of having a piece of rubber that's right here on the exterior that dries out and cracks over time and then that can leak, this is going to last a lot longer. And most of the windows in the unit open up like a rain window so that even while it's raining, you're not getting stuff wet. As you look inside here, this is storage underneath the dinette. You'll notice that all of this is aluminum frame. It's double welded, and an additional wood insert is inside anywhere they screw into, so it has some bite. If you look underneath the competition, it's all gonna be wood. That's super important, as well as the floors are made out of 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking instead of OSB chipboard. Then The reason why that's important is because if you accidentally get something wet, that floor is ruined, and you can imagine replacing a floor with all the cabinetry and slide outs is very labor intensive. So if you can buy something that has plywood decking, vacuum bonded walls, torsion suspension, which this guy has, that gives you independent suspension. It makes it so that the camper has less problems where you don't have a spring that will eventually crack and break. You don't have to worry about the coach twisting in a way that it shouldn't twist because of the independent suspension. As you take a paper clip and bend it back and forth, that's the same thing that you're doing to all the welds as you're moving this guy down the highway as like a mini earthquake. So having the torsion suspension is a lot better for you. That also comes with a 10-year warranty on it. And then it has the easy lube axles. That makes it very easy to keep and maintain all your axles. On the rear of the coach, you have an outside shower with both hot and cold water running to it, as well as your dump valves for both your gray and black tanks. Now, the cool thing about this is it does have 12-volt heat pads on the tanks themselves, as well as additional heat pads around the dump valves. That means you don't have to worry about your tanks freezing nearly as much as you would one that's completely unprotected, because those are rated down to negative 11 degrees. Also, as you look on the back here, you'll notice there's a spot for a Furion backup camera. That's very easy to take off that plate. It already has the wiring all pre-built into it, and it will wirelessly connect to your truck, where you could plug in the little LCD screen into your 12-volt outlet or cigarette lighter, and then it can just mount right on your dash. We carry that backup camera in our parts store. Over here, you'll notice that we have a power awning. Now, this is the Dometic power awning, which is a lot faster than the LCI power awning. So if you need to get it back in a hurry, you can do that. You also have adjustable arms that can lock in place if you want. If you want to be able to divert the water from one way or the other away from your door. Also, you'll notice that there is a plate right here. That's because this camper does come with a TV that you can have inside or outside. So if you want to be able to watch the game, you can put it on the bracket that tilts and you're set. You also have a 110 outlet and your TV antenna outlet right here too. This right here is your black tank flush. So there's sprayers inside the black tank that will flush it out for you instead of having to drag a hose into the camper down the toilet to clean out the black tank or the sewer tank. Also, the outside grill and the table comes with it, and a quick connect so that you can be able to grill outside, and then this actually comes off and you can set it on the ground and work with it that way as well. Outdoor speakers, as well as a bug light if you want, and lights all the way across the entire awning to be able to light this up at night. Large grab assist handle. You also have the aluminum rims instead of the white painted rims, so those are gonna not rust out on you like a normal wheel would. And then you'll notice that the top of this door is radius. That's important because if you have one side or the other of this awning down and you accidentally brush against that, that's not gonna have a pokey corner that will rip your awning fabric over time. Also, I wanted to show you that you have storage underneath here, and you can access this storage from the inside underneath the couch as well. And then you have a solar port right here, so if you want to plug in a portable solar panel and put it out in the sun, you can recharge your batteries. And then you have a quick recovery hot water heater. This hot water heater will give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour because you can run it off both gas and electric from this guy. Come on inside and we'll show you some features on the inside here. As you can see, there's tons of storage, lots of beds, lots of room right here. And over here, you'll notice this tip out isn't fully set up because we took that down, and then the last step is to put that bar in place. So the way this guy works is this has a crease in the bed so that you can fold it away, and then this bar slips right into a little slot on here. And then there's three adjustments on here to make this as tight or loose as you want. And then that's all there is to set up the bed, which is kind of nice. This, like I said, is an inner spring mattress, so it's a little bit more comfortable than just the mattress pad. And there's a spot on here to be able to plug in the bed, so if you wanted to turn on some heat, you can do that as well. The controller for that is usually in one of these drawers. Let me show you what that looks like. Let me see if I can find them actually. Ah, probably over here. Yep, So this is what the controller looks like. There's one for each of the three beds. There's just a setting from 0 to 6. This guy plugs in right here and then plugs into a 110 outlet. So keep in mind that will not run unless you're plugged into either a generator or shore power. The other thing this comes with is a fan slash bunk light. So this is a power outlet right here. And then you have two settings for the fan and then lights on and off. So pretty handy. Also, you get a spatula with a bottle opener. You also get a paper towel holder. You also get a spot to put towels for your bathroom. Also, you get the toilet paper holder. They purposely don't put those things on at the factory because you might have a preference on where you like those things. And then last but not least, this is a 10,000 gallon water filtration system that is a residential grade filter. This will filter down to 0.9 micron. That is really important because if you are close to your weight or you just don't want to pull all that extra weight with your water, you can maybe put 5 or 10 gallons of water in your system just so that you have something for on the road, and then be able to hook up to the water at the campsite or at the nearby gas station and not have to worry about what kind of water is going into your lines and through your system. Super helpful. Speaking of extra sleeping room, you also have, in addition to the three queen size tip out beds, this guy folds into a bed as well, the dinette does. So you can push a button and this turns into a bed, and then these right here go in the middle to form the bed. Also, by having this be a king U-shaped dinette, you get a little bit more room to be able to feed everybody, as well as you can put some extra area to eat right here if you put one of those little tiny fold-out TV trays or tables. Over here, you have some storage. And over here, I wanted to point out that these have the pleated shades, so they're a little bit nicer than the mini blinds that kind of rattle around. And then over on this side, this also turns into a bed. So the way this works is it just rolls over. It has a leg that locks into place. And then this couch rolls up. So if you want to be able to access that from the outside, you can. And this makes it very easy to access your bypass valves, which you'll need to be able to access for winterization. That's on your water heater. This folds up just as easy. And then the other thing, other than the storage up here and over here, I wanted to point out is this roof. So most of the time, you'll have vacuum bonded or some kind of laminated walls on the side, and then the roof is just a wood trust roof system. This guy is a solid laminated roof. Now, if you do that to any other coach other than the Rockwood, you will put a hole through the roof. This guy has double ducted air conditioning throughout, as well as the high powered Create a Breeze fan right here, LED lights, and then this roof is walkable across the entire thing, whereas the other types of campers, you might have to worry about it either one, not being a walkable roof, or two, you'll have to stay in between the roof trusses so that you don't fall through. Over here, you have your control panel. This controls your power awning, your power slide outs, your interior and porch lights, your awning lights, your water tank. So if you wanted to be able to heat the electric side or the gas side, you can do both here. The tank heaters for both your black and gray tanks are here, your water pump, as well as your monitor panel to tell you how much battery you have, how full your tanks are. In addition to all the storage that we've mentioned over the dinette, under the couch, in the front, above the couch, the netting above there, you also have more storage above the sink. This is all nice raised panel cabinetry instead of the flat panel, so it's gonna last a little bit longer. It's a little bit more sturdy. And then there's a phone number right here, or a sticker, I should say, and it's the 24/7 roadside assistant. It's called CoachNet that all you get on every single brand new Forest River coach for 1 year. You'll notice that all of this is flush, so they make good use out of all the space they possibly can to be able to use this as counter space as well as double for sink and range top space. You also have a knife rack back here. Now you'll notice this is the only mini blind that we have in the entire coach. That's because for fire code reasons and also for splatter reasons. So you don't want spaghetti on your pleated fabric shade. Microwave, this is a larger oven. This is the 22 inch oven. Most of the ovens are about half this size, so that's really nice. Pots and pans drawer, more storage underneath here, more that pulls out, a scrubby brush spot, more storage here, more pantry storage over on this side. This refrigerator is a two-way refrigerator. We've optioned it with the raised panel cabinetry so it matches all the rest of the cabinetry in the unit. The cool thing about an RV refrigerator is it can run off both electric power, which is 110 power, or gas power. That's important because if you go boondocking where you're not plugged into anywhere, this refrigerator can still keep your food cold. Over here, you'll notice that you have your TV that comes with the unit. This is the same one that you can take outside as well. And then it's on a swing arm bracket. So if you want to be able to see it better from this side or be able to see it better outside, you can pull that off. It also has a TV antenna booster on top, which the button for that is right over here. So you just turn the little LED light that will turn this guy on. And then right here is your iRV Technologies radio. The way this works is you can control the inside speakers, the outside speakers. It has a DVD player built into it, as well as a 5-volt charger for your cell phone, as well as an HDMI and an aux in and Bluetooth. So all of that, and you can download an app on your phone to be able to control things as well. In the rear of the coach, you'll notice you still have the other two beds here. You'll notice that all the bars in here are powder coated instead of the aluminum, so it doesn't oxidize and get marks on top of your fabric or your, it's actually not even a fabric. It's more of a vinyl type material, which is much easier to clean. It's also more weather and rain resistant compared to the kind that you have to spray all the seams. All the seams, by the way, have a stitching in it that is UV protected. So that means that's not gonna degrade like other types of stitching. This all has a 5-year warranty on it, as well as breathable canvas on all the sides so that the camper can breathe and not cause as much condensation. And I wanted to show you that bar that I was telling you about so that the camper doesn't bow over time on the tip outs. That black bar is what I was talking about. So there's one of those on every single tip out in the unit. And then if you look at the competition, again, like I said, I have not seen them be able to pull that off for whatever reason. You also have storage underneath here that you can access from the inside, as well as a bedroom satellite connection and TV antenna and 110. And then up here on the side, you have a TV backer. So if you wanted a TV for these guys back here, you can pull that off. And then more storage above here, obviously. And then these guys pull all the way across so that you can give some privacy to each of the bed areas. And then back here, they have more netting and the power outlets. So you can pull this across. This guy has more storage right here, another 110 outlet, and then this is an emergency exit. So you can unzip just the screen so that you let air in, but not the bugs in, or you can unzip all of this so that you can escape out of here in a hurry in the back end. One of the disadvantages of an air conditioner is you do have to be plugged into a 30 amp source. That means you're having to be plugged into a generator or a campsite power. The beauty of this particular coach is that it has two max air vent fans, one in the living room and then one in the bathroom. And the one in the bathroom can be run and used even though that the door is closed. You'll notice there's a gap up here to be able to move airflow through the camper without having to have that door open. Inside here, you'll notice this is all glass instead of just the shower curtain. And you still have lots of elbow room to move through here. You have the skylight, so you have a lot of natural light as well as extra headroom to work with. This is ducted air into here if you are plugged into AC, as well as LED lights throughout that you can control just with the push of a button on the side of the wall. This has a good size linen closet on the side, as well as a large basin sink. soap holder, toothbrush holder, towel rack, as well as medicine cabinet up here, and then more storage underneath with a GFI protected outlet. So thanks for joining me on the Rockwood ROO 23SS. This has everything that you would want if you want to sleep a lot of people, obviously. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below, or you can email us at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. If this one doesn't quite fit everything you're looking for, we also have a few other different ROO models. Check out our website, thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, to see all those different floor plans that we have. We also do financing here. We're set up with about 15 different lenders, so whether you have perfect credit and looking for that aggressive rate and term, or if you have a few dings on your credit and you need a lender that's a little bit more flexible, we can work with you both ways. We also take trade-ins, so if you have that pop-up that you're tired of setting up and tearing down, come check this one out. This sets up in about half, well, not even half, a quarter of the time that a pop-up would take. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.